open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Blessed are you, Creator of all. To you be praise and glory forever. As your dawn renews the face of the earth, bringing light and life to all creation, may we rejoice in this day you have made. As we wake, refreshed from sleep, open our eyes to behold your presence and strengthen our hands to do your will, that the world may rejoice and give you praise. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. The night has passed and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you now and forever. Amen. Psalms 14, 15 and 16. The fool has said in his heart, there is no God. Corrupt are they and abominable in their wickedness. There is no one that does good. The Lord has looked down from heaven upon the children of all, to see if there is anyone who is wise and seeks after God. But everyone has turned back, all have alike become corrupt. There is none that does good, no, not one. Have they no knowledge, those evildoers? Who eat up my people as if they ate bread, and did not call upon the Lord. There shall they be in great fear. For God is in the company of the righteous, though they would confound the counsel of the poor. Yet the Lord shall be their refuge, though that Israel's salvation would come out of Zion. When the Lord restores the fortunes of his people, then will Jacob rejoice and Israel be glad. Lord, who may dwell in your tabernacle, who may rest upon your holy hill, whoever leads an uncorrupt life, and does the thing that is right, who speaks the truth from the heart, and bears no deceit on the tongue, who does no evil to a friend, and pours no scorn on a neighbour, in whose sight the wicked are not esteemed, but who honours those who fear the Lord, whoever has sworn to a neighbour, and never goes back on that word, who does not lend money in hope of gain, nor takes a bribe against the innocent, whoever does these things, shall never fall. Preserve me, O God, for in you have I taken refuge. I have said to the Lord, you are my Lord. All my good depends on you. All my delight is upon the godly that are in the land, upon those who are noble in heart, though their idols are legion that many run after. Their drink offerings of blood I will not offer, neither make mention of their names upon my lips. The Lord himself is my portion and my cup. In your hands alone is my fortune. My share has fallen in a fair land. Indeed, I have a goodly heritage. I will bless the Lord who has given me counsel. And in the night watches, he instructs my heart. I have set the Lord always before me. He is at my right hand, I shall not fall. Wherefore my heart is glad and my spirit rejoices. My flesh also shall rest secure, for you will not abandon my soul to death, nor suffer your faithful one to see the pit. You will show me the path of life. In your presence is the fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures for evermore. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. First Book of Kings, chapter 4, beginning at the 29th verse. God gave Solomon very great wisdom, discernment, and breadth of understanding, as vast as the sand on the seashore, so that Solomon's wisdom surpassed the wisdom of all the people of the East, and all the wisdom of Egypt. He was wiser than anyone else, wiser than Ethan the Ezraite, and Heman the Chalcol, and Dada the children of Nahor. His fame spread throughout all the surrounding nations. He composed 3,000 proverbs, and his songs numbered 1,005. He would speak of trees, from the cedar that is in the Lebanon to the hyssop that grows in the wall. He would speak of animals and birds and reptiles and fish. People came from all the nations to hear the wisdom of Solomon. They came from all the kings of the earth who had heard of his wisdom. Now King Hiram of Tyre sent his servants to Solomon when he heard that they had anointed him king in place of his father. For Hiram had always been a friend to David. Solomon sent word to Hiram, saying, "You know that my father David could not build a house for the name of the Lord his God because of the warfare with which his enemies surrounded him until the day the Lord put them under the soles of his feet. But now the Lord my God has given me rest on every side. There is neither adversary nor misfortune. So I intend to build a house for the name of the Lord my God, as the Lord said to my father David, 'Your son, whom I will set on your throne in your place, shall build the house for my name.' Therefore, command that cedars from the Lebanon be cut for me. My servants will join your servants, and I will give you whatever wages you set for your servants. For you know that there is no one among us who knows how to cut timber like the Sidonians." When Hiram heard the words of Solomon, he rejoiced greatly and said, "Blessed be the Lord today, who has given to David as a wise son to be over this great people." Hiram sent word to Solomon, "I have heard the message that you have sent to me. I will fulfill all your needs in the matter of cedar and cypress timber. My servants shall bring it down to the sea from the Lebanon. I will make it into rafts to go by sea to the place you indicate. I will have them broken up there for you to take away, and you shall meet my needs by providing food for my household." So Hiram supplied Solomon's every need for timber of cedar and cypress. Solomon, in turn, gave Hiram 20,000 cores of wheat as food for his household, and 20 cores of fine oil. Solomon gave this to Hiram year by year. So the Lord gave Solomon wisdom, as he promised him. There was peace between Hiram and Solomon, and the two of them made a treaty. "I have given you as a light, and I have called you in righteousness. Thus says God, who created the heavens, who fashioned the earth and all that dwells in it, who gives breath to the people upon it, and spirit to those who walk in it. I am the Lord, and I have called you in righteousness. I have taken you by the hand and kept you. I have given you as a covenant to the people, a light to the nations, to open the eyes that are blind, to bring out the captives from the dungeon, from the prison those who sit in darkness. I am the Lord, that is my name. My glory I give to no other. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. It was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. I have given you as a light to the nations, and I have called you in righteousness." The Acts of the Apostles, chapter 15, beginning at the first verse. Then certain individuals came down from Judea and were teaching the brothers, unless you are circumcised according to the custom of Moses, you cannot be saved. And after Paul and Barnabas had no small dissension and debate with them, Paul and Barnabas and some of the others were appointed to go up to Jerusalem to discuss this question with the apostles and the elders. So they were sent on their way by the church, and as they passed through both Phoenicia and Samaria, they reported the conversion of the Gentiles and brought great joy to all the believers. When they came to Jerusalem, they were welcomed by the church and the apostles and the elders, and they reported all that God had done with them. But some believers, who belonged to the sect of the Pharisees, stood up and said, "It is necessary for them to be circumcised and ordered to keep the law of Moses." The apostles and the elders met together to consider this matter. After there had been much debate, Peter stood up and said to them, "My brothers, you know that in the early days God made a choice among you, that I should be the one through whom the Gentiles would hear the message of the good news and believe it. And God, who knows the human heart, testified to them by giving them the Holy Spirit, just as he did to us, and in cleansing their hearts by faith, he has made no distinction between them and us. Now, therefore, why are you putting God to the test by placing on the neck of the disciples a yoke that neither our ancestors nor we have been able to bear? On the contrary, we believe that we will be saved through the grace of our Lord Jesus, just as they were." The whole assembly kept silence and listened to Barnabas and Paul as they told of all the signs and wonders that God had done through them according to the Gentiles. After they had finished speaking, James replied, "My brothers, listen to me. Simeon has related how God first looked favourably on the Gentiles to take from among them a people for his name. This agrees with the words of the prophets, as it is written, 'After this, I will return, and I will rebuild the dwelling of David, which has fallen. From its ruins I will rebuild it, and I will set it up, so that all other peoples may seek the Lord, even the Gentiles, over whom my name has been called.' Thus says the Lord, who has been making these things known from long ago. Therefore I have reached the decision that we should not trouble those Gentiles who are turning to God, but we should write to them to abstain only from things polluted by idols, and from fornication, and from whatever has been strangled, and from blood. For in every city, for generations past, Moses has had those who proclaim him, for he has been read aloud every Sabbath in the synagogue." "Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine. Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned. I have called you by name, you are mine. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine." "They who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as an eagle. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, who has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Saviour, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets God promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our ancestors, and to remember his holy covenant, This was the oath God swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of all their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. They who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as an eagle. And so let us pray. Continue to pray for the life of the Church, for your blessing on all that we do. Continuing our prayers for the Deanery of Reigate, pray for the parish of St Mary Magdalene, Reigate, for Richard Wilson, Erin Gilmore, Catherine Capper, Nigel Griffiths, and Danielle Robinson, the clergy. Within our parish we pray for Heath Church and Mill Church, Reigate. Within the wider Anglican Communion we pray with and for the bishops, priests and people in the Diocese of Oxford in England and Central Melanesia in the province of Melanesia. We remember the life and writings of St. Hildegard of Bingen. We pray for all in our own day who are visionaries within the Church. We give thanks for all engaged in Christian art, in the link between art, music and spirituality. Pray for the meeting of the Parochial Church Council this evening, for those who will be present, those who will take part on Zoom, with deliberations, for the preparations for the annual Parochial Church meeting next month. Pray for all locally who are involved in providing local services through the social services, or who work with the young or the elderly. And we pray for all emergency and rescue organisations, particularly those working within Greater London. Most glorious and holy God, whose servant Hildegard, strong in the faith, was caught up in the vision of your heavenly courts. By the breath of your Spirit, open our eyes to glimpse your glory, and our lips to sing your praises with all the angels. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so in faith and love we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless us and preserve us from all evil, and keep us in eternal life. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Mass according to the Book of Common Prayer will be celebrated and live streamed at 10 a.m. Compline will be at 9 p.m.